Hi, I'm Victor, Simulation Specialist at PLM Group. In this video, I'll show you some partitioning and hex meshing with Simulia on the 3D Experience platform. So let's work with this model of this little staircase. Let's do a good partitioned hex mesh of one of the sections between the steps. So this one here. So I'm going to open it first. Let's open it in a new app. And now it's open in the collaborative lifecycle, and we can change app if needed by going to the compass and finding the right app. So to create a good mesh, we need to partition this, and we cannot make any changes to the original shape because it's made in another CAD system. So that's not CATIA 3D Experience. Maybe it's made in SolidWorks in this case, or in another system, or maybe it's an imported geometry. So let's use the little trick of the abstraction shape. So let's put an abstraction shape here. So I'm going to go to the insert and insert the abstraction shape. And let's rename it. And let's rename it to something good. Maybe like this. And I will double click on it and see where we end up. And now it's going to open in, now it opened in the correct app right away. So there are a few apps you can use for this. And the preferred one is one of the geometry idealization apps. And here, with this one open in this app, we can now make a copy of the original body, like so, and we can paste it in the abstraction shape. I'm going to use the paste special tool and paste it as a result with link, and that means that if I do a change to the original body and update, then the changes will also be here. And now the link is okay, we have the thumbs up, and now we can make changes here. Let's hide this one, so the original shape, so there is no confusion what we're actually looking at. And now what we're seeing is the copy. So let's do the partitioning. So we're going to split this so it can be meshed nicely with hex elements. So I'm going to use the partition tool here. So the idealize, partition, and we're going to partition the whole volume. And we can use faces and planes for partitioning. So we're going to use this face here to make a nice cut, infinite extrapolation just to be sure. And now we're going to have two partitions. We can see the partitioning line here. So let's do a second one, partition, and now it's this volume. And the cutting element is going to be this face down here, infinite. And okay, now we have three partitions, and we can make more. Maybe we want to split the holes, for example. We have two planes here that could be used nicely already, so let's use them right away. So I'm going to partition this, this, and this volume. And let's use this plane. Another cut here. One more partition. So that would be, well, all the volumes. And now we have this plane instead. Let me make sure I have all the volumes. Now, we could make more planes if we want to make an even nicer cut. Maybe we want to cut all the other holes as well, so that we have, maybe we will get better distribution about the elements, about the holes. But this is fine as it is. Let's use this one. So let's do the mesh. So I'm going to right click here and see that I cannot really do anything. That's because I'm not in the top level. There's nothing to insert here. I can't insert a FEMRAP. So what I like to do is to go to the top level, double click it, and we end up in the collaborative lifecycle. And one of the assembly apps could be fine also. So let's right click, and now we can insert something here. So now we can insert a finite element model. So let's do that. And let's double click on that one. Now we need to make a choice first, which shape is going to be meshed. So we have the original geometry, or we have the abstraction shape with the partitions. So let's use the partitioned one. So only this one. And And then we can use the mesh tools here. Let's do a partition hex mesh. And then let's select support. So I'm going to make sure I select now the body in the abstraction shape and not something from the original shape. And this is hidden still, so that's good. And then we can make some changes here. I'm going to have hex only elements, 5 millimeter mesh size. We can go into the edit all parameters and we can check that we're going to use quadratic elements, hex only, and the size again here. Now we can save this as a rule so we can refer to it later. Okay. And since I didn't click mesh but just click OK, the mesh is not here, so I need to click the update or the Control U. So let's do that one. And now we get a mesh that is kind of okay in the distribution. It's not perfect around the holes, but we still have two smooth layers on each flange, and pretty good. We can make a lot more changes. If I go back into the partition mesh here, we can go into the edit tool here. This I might cover in another video. And here we can assign sweep techniques and structure techniques and work more to prove the mesh around the holes, for example. So this is a sort of a side app. Let's exit this one. And now to finish this one, all I need to do is go to the properties, create a solid section, and remember to select here the body that is the support for the mesh, so in the abstraction shape. The material is already assigned, so it's picked up automatically. And a Control U or click the update button, and then we have a finite element model ready to use. And just renaming it here. That's it. Thanks for watching.